The church, hear me, is to minister to children who have no respect for authority. Our call of the church is to minister to children who are angry but don't know what their issue is.
Come on.
The call of the church is to minister to children who reject morals, values, and discipline. The call of the church is to track down the children who have no goals, who have no dreams, who have no fathers, who have no fears, and have no education. The call of the church is to go and embrace children tattoos, who have piercings, and who have lost their mind on illicit drugs and illicit behavior. The call of the church is to not be afraid of the children we are supposed to discipline.
Come on.
The call of the church is to go to the street corners and not just minister and embrace the children who are lovable, warm, and fuzzy, and know the 23rd Psalm and John 3:16, and sit in with barrettes and Bobby Johnson. But the call of the church is to go get the children who are wearing their pants behind their
clothes,
who don't have their hair done, who have tattoos on their neck, who believe that anybody who corrects them is a threat to their humanity. The call of the church is not just to applaud the little babies in the children's choir and to say, isn't that nice for the kids who get the college scholarships, but the call of the church is to go down the Lexington Market and to tell them you are still loved and you are still valuable and we still see the glory of God that is on your life. The call of the church is to go get the teenage girl who at 17 doesn't even want to be a girl but wants to be a boy. The call of the church is
to embrace
the 15-year-old who already has two children and another one on the way. The call of the church is for the young man who feels like his manhood is only defined by a gun in his waist pocket and going to prison is a badge of honor. The call of the church is to go to the children who don't even think that church is an option, that graduation is even something that is doable, that college is even something that is attainable. The call of the church is to go get your nieces and nephews, your godchildren, and your neighbor's children who won't even speak to you anytime. We're living in an age that 70-year-olds are being beat and raped in parks when those are our grandmothers, and our children don't even have a cinch to honor those who are, in fact, the badges in the corners of our community. The call of the church is not for you to come to church and feel comfortable and to sit there as if you've arrived and the favor is just on you. But the call of the church is, when I hear the benediction, I won't stop driving. Here it is, because I don't even have to go a block to go to that hotel on the corner and to shake that girl and tell her there's more to your life than what some stripper and some pimp and some John has told you. But you are fearfully and wonderfully made. The call of the church is understanding that God has made us to be rulers and to be joint heirs and not to be beneath but to be above. And lest you forget, if it were not for the grace of God, you would be one of those children. If it were not for the grace of God, you would be lost on that street corner.
Come on, man. Yes.
Let the church say amen.
It's okay, baby.
Let the church say amen. God has called. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let the church, let them say amen. If you believe the word, let the whole church. So let the church say amen. Lift your hands, lift your hands. God has spoken. So let the church.